On May the 1st, 1851, Queen Victoria opened the Great Exhibition in Hyde Park, London. 100 years later, history repeated itself when, on May the 3rd, 1951, from the steps of St. Paul's Cathedral, Queen Victoria's great-grandson, King George VI, opened another great exhibition of Britain's achievements, the Festival of Britain.
Let us welcome to our shores of the many members of our British Commonwealth and all the visitors from other lands who have come to see what this old country can do. And let us pray that by God's good grace, the vast range of modern knowledge which is here shown may be turned from destructive to peaceful ends, so that all people, as this century goes on, may be lifted to greater happiness. I declare the Festival of Britain open and wish it a universal success.
By this time, Prince Charles had a baby sister, Princess Anne. And for Princess Elizabeth, this must have meant an increasing struggle between the claims of motherhood and the constant demands of public service. Her husband was still serving with the Royal Navy. And soon after the birth of the baby princess, he had to return to the Mediterranean fleet to his new command, the frigate Magpie. Since 1948, the King's health had caused grave anxiety, and the burden of public life had devolved more and more upon Princess Elizabeth. On June the 7th, 1951, as the King's deputy, and dressed in the scarlet uniform of the Grenadier Guards, the Princess rode onto the Horse Guards parade in London to review His Majesty's Brigade of Guards and to take the salute. It was the ceremony of trooping the colour in honour of the King's official birthday. At the end of the ceremony,
led by the Colonel of the Grenadier Guards, Her Royal Highness Princess Elizabeth, riding away from us now slowly across the great parade ground, the sun shining on the golden accoutrements that she wears over her scarlet tunic, her golden belt, her blue garter sash, and on the blue garter sash of the Duke of Gloucester, who rides his grey horse to her left, and behind her, reformed, a part of the royal procession, but only a small part, because pride of place, the honour of place now, behind Her Royal Highness, comes to the foot guards. With this complicated ceremony ended, now follow her on their way back towards Buckingham Palace.